Welcome back to Chemistry Matters, Unit 7, where we're looking at ways to express the concentration of solutions. By now, you should have completed the molarity lab. Our students have performed this lab as well, so let's get back to our classroom to see how they did.
Okay, guys, let's look at the solutions you created. What do you observe?
We didn't have the exact same problem, but our solutions had the same color.
Why do you think that is?
Well, we made different volumes, but the concentrations are the same.
Exactly. You both just made different volumes of one molar solutions. So the concentrations are the same, and therefore the colors are the same. Nice work.
There you go. It looks like our students have a pretty solid handle on expressing the concentration of solutions in two different ways, using either mass percent or molarity. They know how to create solutions of known concentrations if they have the solute in solid form. But what happens if the starting substance is already a solution and it's too concentrated? What I'm talking about is a process most of us are familiar with. When we brew coffee or tea that's too strong, we can add water to it to make it taste better. The same thing can happen if a lemonade or juice drink is too strong. We can simply add some water to the solution to dilute it. This happens quite a bit in the chemistry lab, too. Not to produce solutions that are more dilute so we can drink them, but to take a concentrated, or sometimes referred to as stock, solution and lower its concentration to a more suitable level. This procedure is known as dilution. The way that chemists achieve this is through the dilution equation, which is represented by M1 times V1 equals M2 times V2, where M1 equals initial molarity, V1 equals initial volume, M2 equals the molarity after dilution, and V2 equals volume after dilution. In real-life situations, chemists almost always solve for V1, since that represents the volume of the initial concentrated stock solution that we need to draw out to dilute. We typically know the final volume and the desired concentration of the solution after the dilution. Let's head back to our classroom, where our students are getting some hands-on experience working with dilutions.
First, I'd like you to use your whiteboards to work a dilution problem with your partner. Then, I'll ask you to actually perform a dilution of your own after we've had some practice with the math. Maria, will you read the problem?
Sure. We want to prepare 500 milliliters of a 1.00 molar acetic acid solution from a 17.5 molar stock solution of acetic acid. What volume of the stock solution is required?
Thanks. Now see if you can all figure out how we should proceed.
Okay. V1 is usually what we're solving for in dilution problems, right?
Right. V1 is the volume of the concentrated solution that we'll need to measure out. Then we can add the volume of water necessary to finish the problem.
Okay. So if we use M1 times V1 equals M2 times V2, and we rearrange for V1, we know that M1 represents the molarity of the stock solution, which is 17.5 molar. V1 is the volume of the stock solution that we need to measure to dilute. Solving for V1, we get 28.6 milliliters. That means we would need 28.6 milliliters of the stock solution.
Okay, is that it? Is that all we have to do?
Yes, for this problem, that's all you would need to do, since it's only asking for the volume of the stock solution required. How about you two? Did you get the same thing?
We did, but we didn't rearrange the equation like they did. We just plugged in 1.0 molar and 500 milliliters on the right-hand side of the equation and used 17.5 M1 times V1 on the left-hand side.
And then we divided 17.5 molar into 500 milliliters. I think it's basically the same thing, though.
Yes, it's the same. Team 1 did some algebra first to get the unknown variable by itself. You guys plugged in first. Either way, it's correct. Both groups found that you'd need 28.6 milliliters of stock solution. But the final volume of the diluted solution should be 500 milliliters. What's making up the rest of the volume?
Isn't it water?
471.4 milliliters of water, I think.
Exactly right. Since water is the solvent, it makes up the difference in volume. If there were a different solvent, it would make up the difference. Now, What I'd like for you to do is to make a dilution of your own. Both groups will use the volumetric flasks and distilled water. I'd like for team one to come up with a plan to create 100 milliliters of 0.08 molar copper 2 nitrate from your stock solution of 1 molar of copper 2 nitrate. Team two, I'd like you to come up with a plan to create 100 milliliters of 0.005 molar copper 2 nitrate solution from your stock solution of 1 molar copper 2 nitrate. Once I've approved your procedure, you can get started.
While our students come up with their plans for creating their dilutions, we'll take a break to let you do two things. Come up with plans of your own, and then execute this lab. A guide to this dilution activity, listing all necessary materials, can be found in the Chemistry Matters Toolkit. When you're done, I'll see you at the top of the next video on the playlist to take a look at our students' plans as well as their results. I'll see you there.